Well, drug traffickers, murderers, money launderers, all kinds of criminals make this famous list. It's the FBI's 10 Most Wanted. The program was created 65 years ago this week. But did you know how it got started? It got started by a pitch from a journalist. In 1949, a reporter approached the agency about a story on the toughest guys on the run. Well, that article got the attention of the then FBI director, J. Edgar Hoover, who officially launched the 10 Most Wanted Fugitives program on March 14, 1950. And now the results speak for themselves. Since the program's start, 504 fugitives have appeared on the list. 473 have been caught or located. And 156 of those fugitives were found as a direct result of citizen cooperation. Now here with more on the 10 Most Wanted, Joseph Campbell, Assistant Director of the FBI's Criminal Investigative Division. I guess it's a happy anniversary to you, Joe, on this list.
Well, that's right. We've had over 90% recovery in regard to that, and that's thanks to the help of a lot of partners and the general public.
You know, I don't have to tell you this. I certainly don't need to tell our viewers this as well. There's a lot of bad people in this world. I'm just wondering, how do you pick who makes the top 10 list?
Right. Well, we look for criminals that are out there who've exhibited egregious, horrific behavior, committed heinous crimes, and in addition, those that we believe this national and international publicity will assist in helping us to apprehend them.
We were thinking about the television show as well, America's Most Wanted, and I'm just curious why you think this list has been so effective.
Well, I think that it appeals to the public. A lot of the public likes to watch those types of criminal shows and determine ways in which they can assist. And now with the advent of the Internet, we've got the list on our website at FBI.gov. We've got information on Twitter, Facebook. We've even got a smartphone app that can push that information out to the public.
Interesting, a smartphone app. Okay, Joe, you know what? I'd like to catch some bad guys today. How about that? Do you want to try that, Joe? We should go ahead. You never know. We might get lucky. And I was looking at the top 10 list, and there's a few names that I think our viewers will be very familiar with, including this one, which we've done extensive reporting on, Yasser Abdel Saeed. He is the man who allegedly killed his teenage daughters in these honor killings. And I was looking through what you have on the website, $100,000 reward, but you go into some great specifics about how to locate him and what he liked. Tell us a little bit about this guy.
Well, right. He's traditionally been a cab driver, and so we think there's a good chance that that's the type of vocation he could still be involved in. He is from Egypt, so we don't know if possibly he's traveled back over there or is traveling back and forth or is in contact with relations in New York and so forth. So we put those characteristics out and, of course, his physical characteristics out to the public, hoping that somebody can pick up a tip and provide us some information to apprehend him.
You know, it's interesting. One of the things that you write down is that he loves dogs, especially tan and black colored German Shepherds. I thought that was interesting. You never know when you bump into somebody and think, he looks sort of familiar, and he was checking out this dog, and maybe that leads to his capture. You never know what's going to work. There's another criminal on the run, Robert William Fisher. His crime dates back further to 2001, where he's wanted for allegedly killing his wife and two young children and then blowing up his house in Scottsdale, Arizona. Any beat on where this guy might be?
Well, we're still looking for information, hoping the public will pick up on something, but that's an especially egregious act. Here he allegedly killed innocently his wife and then two children. And I believe that any time that kids are victims of these kinds of criminals, we really need to put in a full court press effort to apprehend them. And again, we're asking for the public's help. Any information they think they might have, no matter how minor, we're very interested in getting that type of information.
Great resources on your website. You say Fisher is physically fit, an avid outdoorsman, hunter, fisherman. And you even give some very specific physical descriptions of him. So I encourage our viewers to check out FBI.gov, the app, and everything else. Joe, it's great to have you on the program. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.